Gates, Dr. Dr. PK.
Let me explain to you how this oxygen sensor works. So this is an oxygen sensor. It's done, which is used to monitor the amount of oxygen in the exhaust. This one we have just removed from the bank one of Toyota Passo. So now what you do, if you want to know that the oxygen sensor is fine, first of all, you do the physical observation. You just observe your oxygen sensor, you do the physical observation. Just look whether the outer layer is cracked or it's dirty. Look at it. Look whether this wire, they are teared. That this wire, this one, it has been joined. Because if you look at this color code, they are different from this one. But we will test it and see whether it is performing well. Now, we want to test our heater circuit, whether it is working properly for this oxygen sensor. So now what you do, you take your multimeter, this multimeter. Then now what we are going to test the resistance for this sensor. Now, you place it at 20 kilo ohms. Place it there. Then now what you do, this circuit, the circuit with the wire which is common, the white wire, these are the one for the heater circuit. So this heater circuit, for this oxygen sensor to work, it has to be heated to approximately 600 degrees. So now what you do, just come, let me check the two white wire here. They've been merged with the black wires. These two, you see these two? So now what you do, you come here, you just check at the probe, black wire, these two probes. Then you hold your meter here. Hold your meter to that probe, and then you observe your meter. Then you take the other probe, then you touch this one, oh, not that one, this one, not that one. Ah, good, that one is reading resistance. So when you see it is reading, they tell you this sensor is okay. Yeah, so this one is good, because now you have the readings. But if it's broken, if this layer is broken, it will not give you the readings. Mm-hmm. It will not give you the readings. So that one is correct. So these two wires, they are used for heater circuit, which is used to heat this sensor to higher degrees, so that it can be able to react. It always reacts with the amount of the oxygen in the exhaust. So what happened to this sensor? It produces its own voltage. When the exhaust fume is passing here, this sensor, it reacts, it compares the amount of oxygen outside and the amount of the oxygen inside the exhaust. When the amount of oxygen is high, then it produces high voltage.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, if you read your meter, if you can be able to use the a flame, you burn here, you need a propane.
Closed.
Propane flame, eh?
Closed.
Then when you hit here and then you hold here, these two wires, these are the ones which are used to produce the voltage. So if you can just test them, you will see it producing voltage from the meter. You just switch your meter to 20 volts, then you hold here, then you burn. When you burn, it will show it produced, it will produce the voltage. But it will require a very high temperature. Yes. So that's how,
so
just
this
test your meter. So this is fine, fantastic, this good. So this switch. Can you
so this can
it?
Work now.
This one can work, it's fine.
Let me go and test it to my car.
So just go and return. Like my YouTube channel, subscribe, leave your comment there. Let's meet in the next video.